Athletes and supporters were eager to hear about plans for the games scheduled for Trinidad and Tobago from April 17th to 21st, 2014 at the UWE Sports and Physical Education Center in St. Augustine. 9 disciplines are on the card: cricket, football, darts, dominoes, netball, volleyball, basketball, table tennis, and drafts. Drafts replace Scrabble to accommodate the Surinamese who are joining the games for the first time and whose first language is Dutch. The Arubans might be the other newcomers. With 2 new teams and the number of sports remaining the same, we asked Samantha how will they ensure that the games do not overrun the schedule.
Not all of the countries are participating in all of the disciplines. Like for instance, Suriname will not be playing cricket or netball. So I think that's what they're relying on.
Females can join their male counterparts on the football and basketball teams. As it relates to cricket, 2 females must be on the team. However, you fellows won't be on the netball courts, as men won't be participating in the female disciplines. Elson Gaskin is the team manager, and Peter Rochester and Edwin McLean his deputies. Elson implored the athletes among us to take this outing seriously and to start preparing for the meet. His aim? To return home with the gold.
We will be taking fresh guard. All right, we will be meeting with the discipline managers. All right, those of them who have not resigned or who are still interested. I don't think that we have the 40 people here who would be representing the bank. It is up to you all to decide how you want to approach these games. My suggestion is to approach it with seriousness and to go to win the games.
The team for the games will comprise 40 athletes and 10 managers. The sports club is counting on the support for the Not Too Athletic to serve as official and unofficial cheerleaders. The cost for each supporter could be $3,000 inclusive of airfare. The club is hoping to offset this cost or some of it through fundraisers.
What we're thinking of having is a Jolly Roger cruise around the 16th and early 23rd of November.
Talking about cruising, the Trinidadians have organized a sail on board the Harbour Master on the Easter bank holiday. Our club president says that these games coincide with the Central Bank of Trinidad and Tobago's 50th anniversary, so they have a heavy entertainment schedule.
So the Thursday night, that's when the games begin with the official opening ceremony. The Friday, they're hosting us to dinner. The venue is still to be confirmed. The Saturday, they're going to have cricket on the light. So the finals for the cricket match will be held. It will be a night match. And then immediately after, they're going to have what they call a real Trini line, where the whole steel pan and the curry, the doubles, everything. On the Sunday is the closing ceremony and the return of the cultural show. And the Monday is a cruise on the Harbour Master.
Well, we on CBB News encourage you to play hard on all fronts, on and off the field. Reporting for CBB News, I am Sandra Whiskey. Looking forward to TNT 2014.